I decided I'd play a little game. I was going to look at 137, put another set of numbers with it that would equal 9. So I played with a few equations and I come up with 137 plus 268 equaled 405, which, casting out 9s, we know equals 9. But I also noticed another set of numbers, putting them together equaled 9. Now what's so special about these two sets? Well, I made a little rule in the game. I could never use the same number twice when I was putting the sets together to equal 9. So, as you can see over here, I've got 137, 268 equals 405. I never used the same number twice. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 0. Same here. 167, 238 equals 405. Never used the same number twice. I brought them down, and I casted out the 9s when I added them up, and they both equaled 396, which equaled 18, which equaled 9. Now that had them looking exactly the same, but I knew there had to be something different about them, so I kept looking, and this is what I found out next. I noticed the two sets of numbers were actually turning into triangles. 167, there's a triangle. And there it is over there. I noticed 137 was a triangle over here. 137. So I thought, okay, I'll make two triangles and I'll overlap them like they are here and put the numbers on them and see what I can find. So I overlapped the two triangles and this is what I found. They were both emanating nines. So again, they were still looking the same. 2 and 7 is 9, 1 and 8 is 9, 6 and 3 is 9, 3 and 6 is 9, 2 and 7 is 9, 1 and 8 is 9. They were still looking the same, but I knew there had to be something different about the two of them. So I kept looking, and this is what I found next. I noticed these two triangles broke my rule, because 2, 6, and 8 equaled 7 after casting out 9s. 1, 3, and 7 equaled 2 after casting out 9s. But the rule was, you couldn't use the same number twice. Well, 2 is here, it's also in the triangle. 7 is in the triangle, it's in the answer. That's using the same number twice. So I knew this wasn't the sequence of numbers I was looking for. So I went to the other two triangles to see what would come out. And then I noticed I wasn't using the same number twice with these two triangles. 2, 3, and 8 equaled 4 after casting out 9s. 1, 6, and 7 equaled 5 after casting out 9s. So there, I never used the same number twice. So I knew that these two were being perfectly numbered because I was always looking for the 9, but the rule was I couldn't use the same number twice. So there it is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I knew this hexagram was perfectly numbered because that was part of the game. Couldn't use the same number twice. So those were the perfect numbers for those two triangles, or Star David, or hexagram, whatever you want to call it. Now I'll show you it emanating the 9. So here's the perfectly numbered hexagram emanating the 9. 1 and 8, 9. 3 and 6, 9. 2 and 7, 9. 9 and 7 and 2, 9. It's emanating the 9 everywhere. So I knew that was a perfectly numbered hexagram. So I added the shape in the middle, and again, the 9 was still being emanated out of each point. 1 and 1 is 2, 8 and 8 is 16, 6 and 1 is 7, 7 and 2 is 9. I did it all the way around and still the 9 was showing. But I also noticed something else. You never see the number 9. You add it all up and it equals 9, but nowhere in this hexagram do you see the number 9. That's the mystery of her. You don't directly see her all the time, but if you keep adding things up, she'll always equal the number 9. Whereas that's the difference with the number 137. You see the number 137, but you never know what she's doing to make herself work. Ask a physicist, he'll let you know about that. So I thought that was pretty interesting, that 9 was coming out everywhere but never seen. 137 is seen, but nobody knows how it works. 9 lets you see how she works, 137 doesn't. So that's the mystery of those two numbers put together. Now I kept going on to the next shape. And again, I found 9 emanating itself out of it all over the place. 3 and 3 is 6, 6 and 6 is 12, 1 and 2 is 3. 3 and 6 equals 9. Again, 9 emanating itself coming out all over the place. But then I noticed the cube. And I thought, that's interesting. Now I'm going to number the cube. Well, I've got it all numbered here perfectly, but I don't have the 1 and the 8 because the rest of the cube isn't shown. So I'll go on to show you that one in just a moment. Because I also wanted to make you aware that whatever numbers are on this side, the other numbers on the other side have to equal 9 to make it perfectly numbered. And they do. If you play with them all the way around, 4 and 3 is 7 plus 1 is 8. Now, if these three numbers equal 8, I know the opposite three numbers are going to have to equal 1 because 8 and 1 is 9. So this is 8. Let's add these three together and see if they come out to 1. 6 and 8 is 14. 4 and 1 is 5. 5 and 5 is 10. There's your 1. You can do it on this side and this side. Whatever number comes out here, whatever number it is, the other number has got to equal 9 to make this perfectly numbered, this geometrical shape. So let's go on now and take a look at the cube. So here's the cube perfectly numbered, and I know that it is because when I add up this side, whatever it comes to, and I add up the other side, whatever it comes to, has to equal the number 9. And it does. 1 and 5 is 6, and 3 is 9, 9 and 7 is 16. Add them together, they equal 7. 6 and 1 is 7. So I know if this side of the cube is 7, that side of the cube has to be a 2. Add them all up, cast out the 9s, and they're a 2. 2 and 6 is 8, 8 and 8 is 16, 6 and 1 is 7, 7 and 4 is 11. 11 is 1 and 1, it equals 2. So I know that's a perfectly numbered cube, because again, 9 is emanating itself, coming out of it, but you can't see the number 9. That's her mystery. So, after putting 1, 3, 7 and the number 9 together, I found that I could perfectly number geometrical shapes. Now, that might mean something to people that play with these geometrical shapes and have been looking for numbers to plug in. Well, I believe if you keep plugging in 1, 3, 7 and the number 9, put the two mystery numbers together, and you'll come out with some pretty interesting findings, just like I did. So, good luck, have some fun, just like I did. Make light of it, don't take it too seriously, and just play. So thanks a lot, Sandra, for watching. I know you enjoyed it because I talked to you all about it and now you finally got to see it. You take care. You have a great day. And thank you each and every one, every other person that did end up watching the videos. I really appreciate you viewing them. Thanks. Bye-bye.